keep that money here in the local economy. So I appreciate what you're saying, because I didn't realize that, Frank. I didn't realize that by accepting these funds, how we don't have the option of only hiring local. And yet, I wonder where that can live. Maybe in the budget conversation, we're asked to bring our ideas to the budget conversation. You know, that is a way that the, you know, we can improve the budget if we can, where possible, when expending funds, keep that money here in the community through good jobs. So maybe that's where it resides. But it certainly has been expressed as a concern before. And I appreciate it being held up again.
Thank you, Ms. Rao. Staff, does the city have a local hiring policy?
We do, yes.
Now,
and they need to make an effort to hire local folks.
Now, that process is not impeded by our getting these federal dollars. You're just talking about a preference lawful or acceptable by the federal government, but we can have a targeted, marketed process for everybody. But specifically, I mean, if we're not talking about, you know, sending our bids to San Jose. We're talking about the Central Coast. We're talking about Salinas. You know, if the targeted marketing effort that we're making for employment opportunities to hire contractors is done more locally, then by and large the folks are going to be paying attention and attend the bid walks and et cetera are going to be local contractors, wouldn't they?
Well, the federal funds actually you can't prohibit anybody from bidding on those jobs. So our policy has been that we go with our lowest responsible bidder. And whoever is the lowest bidder, responsible bidder, does get that job.
That's right. But key word being qualified or responsible.
Responsible, yes. And then we do monitor the contractor. We do a background check on them to make sure they are responsible. And then we recommend council for awarding those jobs.
And this is being that it's EDA money, does it not trigger federal Davis-Bacon requirements?
Yes, wage? We actually pay, it does require prevailing wage. And the state's prevailing wage is generally higher than the Davis-Bacon.
And I thought with Davis-Bacon there was also Section 3 local hiring requirements, isn't there?
I think there is.
So I think the federal government actually does prize and put a premium on, you know, stirring up local economic development activity. So I just would hope that, you know, staff really acquaint themselves with those aspects of the federal dollars and make good use of that targeting. Also, and I just know that again, the federal government is very interested in the tracking of those employment opportunities, and then also targeting minority-owned businesses, women-owned businesses. The maybe weeby requirements that come along with those federal dollars, I think, are still there and probably even more robust these days.
Yeah, yes, they are. Those are all included on the specifications as well.
That's right.
Yeah.
Commissioner Mendez?
Yeah, I just want to segue into your comment there, Chair. We do have a local hire ordinance, but that's just to hire local workers. That doesn't have anything to do with local businesses, local contractors. That's, you know, it just addresses the workers itself. Is that correct?
Well, the city has a local hire policy.
A local hire policy.
Yeah.
Only addresses the workers, not the contractors. Not the contractors that come in and bid the projects.
Correct.
Right, yeah. Right. Mm-hmm. And the feds obviously exclude that. You can't
prohibit.
You can't preclude that, right.
Yeah.
I don't know, maybe if this is the appropriate body maybe to take that up or at some other date, whatever, maybe that's something that we should entertain. Yeah.
I'm not sure whether that's appropriate for right now, but that's certainly good discussion. Commissioner McShane?
Yeah, just to follow up to that, I thought that there was like a 5% incentive for choosing a local business for contracts with the city of Salinas. I mean, granted, this is a little bit of a different incentive situation altogether because it's a federal project. Maybe somebody from the city could clarify on that. Maybe this isn't...
I can clarify that. That's with respect to the purchase of goods and such that, but not...
And services, no?
Not for public work services like this.
Right, different animal altogether, but for goods and I think services as well.
Contracts, not professional services.
Not professional.
But you're correct
services.
That there is. We do have a local local preference and purchasing policy that's in our city code, and it's primarily with respect to the goods purchase of goods.
Okay. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Thank you, Commissioner McShane. Commissioner Rajo.
I would like to make a motion.
Can I just ask a couple more questions?
Discussion can still take place after the motion, but yes.
Thank you for that thought, though. I appreciate that. I think we're almost there. I just thought that there was a couple good, thoughtful questions earlier, and then I saw staff writing down some potential responses, so I thought I'd ask either Ron or Frank to address. I think we talked about recycling, talked about abandoned pipe. There was mention of no security, and then also the CEQA oversight, at least those two items we'd want to talk about those. Would staff have responses to either of those questions?
Yes, as far as the security for the facility, it is gated and it does have a gate locked. It is locked every day after working hours. Staff comes in, caretaker comes in, opens it up in the morning and does some work in and out. And before he leaves at, I believe, 3 o'clock, it's locked back up for the night.
Thank you. I guess you missed our discussion about electrified fences. You guys might want to look into the whole electrified fences.
That was a doozy.
If you can't fight any mad dogs out there for free.
Saw that coming.
Also worth note that the city is also putting together a project that will be coming before you at some point in the not too distant future about making improvements to the treatment facility itself. And those improvements include security fencing. So there are improvements on the way in that regard.
Thank you.
In regard to the question about CEQA and there not being any oversight, it is the lead agency's responsibility who is implementing a project to make the environmental determination. I think most of you are familiar with CEQA in that regard. So in terms of there not being any oversight, there isn't any legal oversight required other than the decision of the lead agency. Oversight generally occurs if there is some in the form of a public forum where people question the conclusions or facts, or, you know, that's also the purpose of sending these documents out for public review, to give people an opportunity to question methodology or conclusions or anything of that nature. So nothing really to be followed up on that point per se.
Gotcha. Thank you very much, Ron. Continuing with commission discussion, if folks are ready for a motion, we're ready to entertain one. Commissioner Mendez.
Yeah. thanks, Chair. If I may, I just want to touch up on some mitigating items here. And I want to go to the biological resources area that addresses the situation with the location of trees. The way I read this, it says that it might be a possibility that any amount of trees could be chopped down for this particular project, right? That's not right? Right, I read it wrong then, okay.
If I may, these trees aren't located within the areas that would be altered by this project. They're located within, I'll back up a little bit, and hopefully I won't confuse you. As part of I mentioned this notion of CEQA plus process before. Normally we're in just a CEQA process, CEQA meaning the state California Environmental Quality Act. The NEPA process, the National Environmental Policy Act, is a similar act, but a national act. When we are receiving funds from a federal agency, we're required to also consider items that are dealt with under the National Environmental Policy Act, because it's a federal agency that's providing the funds. As part of that process, we're required to identify what's called an area of potential effect. And it's the changes that occur within that area that we need to reflect in this document. that area of potential effects includes lands on both sides of the roadways in which these improvements would be made. So the trees you're making reference to are within that area of potential effect, but this project would not directly physically affect them. What this is really addressing is if we've got a tractor or some sort of machinery located adjacent to one of these trees and there are nests in this tree, that activity indirectly can adversely affect the nesting behavior of these birds that are protected, and therefore we have an indirect but significant effect on the birds. So we're not taking trees down directly, but the project could affect their breeding cycle, if you will.
Okay. Well, thanks a lot for that. The way I read it, I guess I interpreted it differently.
Well, you know, these are biologists. You know, they're different. Okay. They're a different breed, no pun intended. You know. Okay.
Thank you.
And also, Chair, on page, on the section where it says mitigation measure CR-1, where's the section that says keep the archaeologist, no, work shall be halted until the find can be evaluated by monitor and or a qualified archaeologist. I don't know about the monitor part. I feel really comfortable with the archaeologist, but I don't know about the monitor part. Could you
What can happen, and it depends on how projects like this are contracted. Maybe Frank, we might want to clarify this one. That's a good point. We do run into situations where contractors have professional staff as part of their private companies that are in a position to actually do this monitoring for the company while the company is doing the work. That's what this alludes to. The qualified archaeologist would be a third-party archaeologist retained by the city to conduct this monitoring while the work is being done by the contractor. So the process of monitoring is what's recorded here. The question is, who does it? So if you were less comfortable with a company doing the monitoring itself, we could take out the word monitor and just leave the qualified
I would
archaeologist
definitely
there.
Feel more comfortable with that. Yeah. And let's see what else here. Oh, that's about it, Chair. Yeah.
Thank you, Commissioner Mendez. Additional questions? We'd like to entertain a motion at this time. Any commissioners would like to make a motion?
I would like to.
Commissioner Rajo.
I move that the commission recommends to the council adoption of the MND and the MMRP with the modification to the line regarding the archaeologist.
Which is?
Omitting qualified monitor, just qualified archaeologist, I believe.
Thank you. Is there a second?
Second.
Seconded by Commissioner McShane. Any discussion on the motion? Seeing none, I'd like to call the question. Roll call vote, please.
Commissioner Rajo?
Yes.
Commissioner Massey?
Yes.
Chairperson Huerta?
Yes.
Commissioner Mendez?
Yes.
Commissioner McShane?
Yes.
Motion passes unanimously. And thank you very much. The Planning Commission's action on this item is a recommendation to the City Council in support of ER-2010-002 Mitigated Negative Declaration and Mitigation Monitoring and Reporting Program for the Industrial Wastewater Conveyance Improvements Project. Staff will schedule the matter for the City Council's consideration, at which time a final decision will be made. Thank you very much, and we will continue on the Salinas Planning Commission agenda. We're at item F, Commission Considerations. Commissioners, anything to consider? Staff? Anything going on?
This is actually your part of the agenda.
Our part of the agenda. Anything crazy you'd like to add, Commissioner McShane? How are you doing, man? You feeling okay? I heard you're running for council or something. Is that...
It's time to plant your spring vegetables and herbs.
That's the best. That's awesome.
Celebrate spring. That's for sure.
I love that column. I look for it all the time.
Thanks.
Anything, commissioners? We'll move on to other business. Item G. Other business, staff.
I don't have any at this time.
Nothing at this time. Item H, follow-up reports. We have at least one or two items.